fakes, puts the hit on, and it's ruled an incompleted pass. And the Bears hitting hard early on, and now tempers flare as the Bears and the Saints going at it. Jamal Brown and Jari Evans of the Saints right in the middle of it.
Well, that got the Bear fans up on their feet. They got the hair in the back of the necks up on a lot of players out there, and that's exactly what this defense is geared to do. Funnel everything to the middle to those two stud linebackers, Lance Briggs and Urlacher, to be able to lay hits on like that. See, Jamal Brown comes down, and he doesn't know that Tremaine McBride doesn't have a free ball to run with, so he's just trying to finish the play. That kind of started the fireworks.
You have to keep going till they blow the whistle. And that's what the Bears did. So the Saints know this is going to be a physical affair. And Steve Weatherford punting on fourth down. And a flag goes down. And activity in the line, and they're going to call a false start against New Orleans. Bill Levy.
False start. Number 50, offense. 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
And how about the hit on Colston? Let's pick it up in real speed now.
Marcus Colston took a hit to the chest last week. He ended up coughing up blood. It created some internal bleeding on him. So he's gotten a hit like that all year, and he keeps getting back up off the turf.
So Weatherford out of the University of Illinois. And again, moving in the line, and penalty flags fly. Already a false start penalty called on the Saints in punt formation. And this one against the Bears.
Neutral zone infraction, number 52, defense, came in the neutral zone, causing an offensive man to false start. 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
So they get the 5 yards back, Jamar Williams. So a heated game early on in this first quarter, Brian.
Yeah, and all it does is create more suspense with Devin Hester back there. Whether Steve Weatherford here can punt away from him. He practiced throughout the morning in pregame warmups, kicking to the corners away from that dangerous weapon.
They've already kicked off to Devin Hester to start the game. Now here's Weatherford again. And Hester will let that one go out of bounds, and it will in the vicinity of the 25-yard line. So Devin Hester, who has returned 3 punts for touchdowns this year, and the Bears go on offense again, leading 3-0.
Sean Payton told us yesterday, Dick, that his number one priority in his game is for Devin Hester not to touch the ball. In fact, he came in with all kind of case studies, worked out all week about onside kickoff returns, kicking it away from this guy. And that's what this Devin Hester has done to the league. It has changed the way you kick to the Bears.
First down on the 29. Here comes pressure in on Orton. And Orton's pass knocked away. Mark Bradley defended downfield by Jason David.
When teams surprise onside kick, that would be in the first 3 quarters of the game, or when your team is leading in the fourth quarter, the success rate is 60%, incredibly high. People don't think realize that. Look for Sean Payton today, maybe pull a surprise kick at some point during this game, trying to get an extra possession for the offense.
Meanwhile, Devin Hester is in the slot to the right. Berrien lined up wide to the right as Adrian Peterson on the carry, and Peterson a yard shy of the first down. So Adrian Peterson, who led the Bears to a season's high 139 yards rushing last week, gets 9.
You know, the Bears have a lot of decisions to make with free agents at the end of the season, and one guy that will be here, and Lovie Smith has said, as long as he's the head coach, Adrian Peterson will be right here with them on this team because of his versatility and all of the different things that he can do.
Cedric Benson, of course, out with a broken ankle in week 12. Garrett Wolf is the backup running back. Third down and one, and here is Peterson. And Peterson diving forward, and he gets the first down of the 40.
Those are tough yards in there for Adrian Peterson as well, getting that first down, because the Saints were stacked up inside, almost like a goal line defense. They went right behind Roberto Garza and Olin Krutz here. Krutz gets good push in the middle, and that's who he runs right behind. the leader of that entire offense.
Bears coming in next to last in the NFL in rushing. And whistles and a penalty marker.
Ball starts, number 63 offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
There's Roberto Garza, the right guard. So last in rushing yards attempt, next to last in rushing yards, and 30th. So the Bears offense way down at the bottom. But Lovie Smith, make no mistake about it. He said, we are a running team, but they've got to do a lot better in that department. Devin Hester lining up to the left. Pick up the pressure pretty well. And this pass is caught by Berrien. Goes out of bounds and a first down into Saints territory.
Well, this is play action pass here, Dick. And you're going to see they're working on Jason David, who we talked about earlier in this game. Every team has gone off after Jason David. And after meeting Jason David for the first time yesterday, you can see why. This guy gets the most out of his ability, but he is 5'8", barely 170 pounds. It is hard to compete against some of the giants on the outside.
And a former Colt who played a mostly zone defense. Here's the quick out to Berrien. And Berrien will be wrestled down by a couple of the Saints, including Will Smith and Jason David. And a flag goes down. And Berrien being helped up. So a chippy game to start this one.
After the runner was stopped, personal foul, unnecessary roughness. Number 42 and number 91, defense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Well, they got the big guy, Will Smith, and the little guy, Jason David.
Jason David comes up to her. He reads it right. He's wrestling. Now Will Smith wants to get in on it. Now taking him all the way to the ground out of bounds is the reason for the call. And I think what we're seeing here today, Dick, is two teams that played for the NFC Championship game a year ago. This could be the last game for both teams this year. Just frustrated by what has transpired this season.
And you look at David at 5'8", I think it was more Will Smith than David on that penalty. And there is Wharton trying to get away from trouble on first down and trying to get it to Berrien, and the pass incomplete. Good coverage downfield by Jason Kraft and pressure put on by Charles Grant up front.
Well, Kyle Orton does a good job of escaping. See, he doesn't even see Charles Grant to the last second. Just catches him out of the corner of his eye, out of the periphery there. He's able to buy some time just to get rid of that ball, throw it away, and live for another down without giving up a bad play. He said, you know, when you get down to this part of the field, the worst thing you can do is take a sack and get yourself out of field goal range.
This is the third straight start for Orton. And the pitch going to Adrian Peterson. Peterson cutting upfield. And can't get away from Bullocks. A gain of 7. Well, this week the All-State Bowl Bash comes to Fox, beginning with the AT&T Cotton Bowl Classic, followed by the All-State Sugar Bowl, the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl, the FedEx Orange Bowl, and concluding with the All-State BCS National Championship game between LSU and Ohio State. The All-State Bowl Bash begins New Year's Day, only on Fox. And a stoppage of play and adjusting the clock. With 7:28 to go in the first.
If you talk about that bowl bash, I'll be in Dallas at the Cotton Bowl. Arkansas and Missouri, one of the great quarterbacks in the league, and Chase Daniels against one of the great running backs in Darren.
Great matchup, and just the first of a big week. Here's Peterson going outside. He's got the first down. Adrian Peterson getting inside the 20-yard line. Scott Shanley follows him, but the 5-yard pickup, and the Bears once again threaten.
Watch the right side of this line here, including Greg Olsen here at end. Get the New Orleans Saints on skates here. Olin Cruz comes out, picks off the middle linebacker Mark Cimino right there. They get a little bit of a crease there, and Adrian Peterson, he's not the fastest guy, but he's talented and skilled at finding the hole and getting every bit of yardage out of the hole that's created.
And a smart running back and a good receiver out of the backfield as well. Has 25 yards on 6 carries thus far. First down. Orton throws it to Bradley. Touchdown. sixth catch of the year for Mark Bradley.
He's working on Jason Kraft, who's taken over for Mike McKenzie, who was hurt last week. You see that Kraft just slipped on the turf right there, lost his footing just for a split second. And Kyle Orton had enough protection to stay with Bradley, his number one receiver on that play, to get him the post for the touchdown.
Former second round pick suffered a torn ACL in preseason of his rookie year. Robbie Gould adds the extra point. So here are the Bears, who demolished the Packers 35-7 last week and now open up a 10-0 lead over the Saints with 6:26 to go in the first. Kyle Orton's second touchdown pass of the year and the third quarterback used by Lovie Smith this season, and a 10-0 lead by the Bears. The 19-yard pass to Bradley, capping a 71-yard drive. So Chicago up 10-0. And the kick by Robbie Gould. Chris Barkley. Good return by Barkley, who trips up at the 36. And Ricky Manning got involved, but a good return of 29 yards. Timeout. The Bears up by 10. And back here at Soldier Field, the Bears in front 10-0. And the Bears would like nothing better than to knock off the Packers, which they did last week, preventing them from a possible home field, and the Saints knocking them out of the playoffs. Aaron Stecker joins Pierre Thomas in the backfield, and Thomas fighting for first down yardage. Rookie from the University of Illinois and recruited and played for Ron Turner, the offensive coordinator for Chicago. Close to the first down, and he does have it.
You know, that when that Pierre Thomas came out of high school and Ron Turner recruited him, he was one of the most highly recruited players in the nation, and he got hurt at Illinois. He actually got bruised in the lower leg, and they had to go out and take out some muscle out of the lower leg. It kind of slowed him down a little bit, but he has great strength and great balance. That's what they like.
And he gets the ball again. And stays on his feet after the initial hit and gets into Bears territory, picking up 6 yards before Alex Brown brings him down.
This is a kid that grew up idolizing Walter Payton. That was his the player that he wanted to idolize and be remembered by. And this is his first visit to Soldier Field. Never came here as a kid, never saw a game here. He said he got chills just stepping on the field this morning.
What a thrill it is for Thomas. He's had a couple of good showings earlier in the year. Play action in the pass for Eric Johnson. And the tight end is stopped about 2 yards shy of the first down. Johnson, who has missed the last two games. And Drew Brees, the last two seasons, has been hot as any quarterback in the NFL, and there have been some hot ones.
Yeah, I mean, he was what Sean Payton wanted to build this offense around. He's been every bit of what he wanted there. The one missing component this year to this offense has been Deuce McAllister in the inside power running that he brought to this team.
McAllister went out in the third game for the season. Saints lost their first four. Third down and two, and Brees trying to get it away, and a great rush by Aguinaldo. And Brees never had a chance, and a flag is back down at the 40-yard line.
Intentional grounding, number 9, offense. Pass it down, fourth down.
You're going to see just quick pressure right here, right in Drew Brees' face immediately here by Aguinaldo. And Drew Brees still in that tackle box, just trying to dump off that ball, just trying to get out of his hand to avoid the sack, and that's the right call there.
Loss of 13, and he didn't get the ball near the line of scrimmage and trying to get rid of it. So good pressure up front by the Bears, and Aguinaldo with 9 sacks coming into this game. Fourth down, and Steve Weatherford will be kicking, and Devin Hester goes back once again. One of the great weapons in the National Football League, and playing more and more as a receiver, but the big threat as a return man. And this kick heading out of bounds, and bounces on the 15, and a good kick by Weatherford. Couldn't do his job any better than that. as it goes out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Well, the NFL on Fox coming up next. The Cowboys and the Redskins, this big rivalry, and of course the Redskins with a victory will earn the sixth and final spot in the playoffs as a wild card. Vikings and Broncos, if the Redskins lose, the Vikings can get in with a victory. If both lose, the Saints would need a win to make the playoffs today for them.
Yeah, the Saints need a lot of help. Let me just offer the TO report right from Jerry Jones the other day, talking to him that he's hidden in the hyperbaric chamber, that the ankle should be healed and ready for the playoffs.
First down for the Bears and Kyle Orton at the 9. Play action back on the goal line, and this pass intended for Adrian Peterson is incomplete. But you know, Cowboys Redskins always a great rivalry, and I think no matter who they play, the Cowboys would like nothing better than to knock Washington out of the playoffs.
No question. I think Tony Romo will start later on today. We'll see him, but I think he'll come out along with some other starters. But Brad Johnson, the backup to Tony Romo, who once played for the Redskins, would love to stick it to Dan Snyder and the Redskins.
And he's a pretty capable backup.
Absolutely. He has won a Super Bowl with Tampa Bay.
Second down and 10. Peterson. And the Saints are there. They converge in at the 11-yard line. So the Cowboys, Packers, Seahawks, and Buccaneers are the top 4 seeds. The Giants are number 5, and of course Washington controls their own destiny. And how about the New York Giants and the way they played last night, Brian, against the New England Patriots, going down 38-35, and they won a lot of fans and support for playing hard and playing their main guys throughout.
For all 4 quarters when they didn't have to, I thought it was great for football last night.
Third down and 8. Orton gets time, going on top for Devin Hester. No flag is thrown as the defender did not face the ball. Roman Harper downfield never looked up for the ball as the ball hit him in the back.
Well, here's a play that they should have been running more frequently in Chicago this year. Devin Hester gets behind Jason Kraft. I don't know how that isn't interference. Two guys bodying Devin Hester with the ball in the air. I don't know how they missed that.
And Harper never looked back for the ball, and the crowd showing their disapproval. So Brad Maynard now will kick from the end zone. And Lance Moore looking to give the Saints their best field position of this quarter. And Lance Moore goes out of bounds in Bears territory with 3:11 in the first quarter. And talking about that tremendous game last night, a 12-point lead by the Giants. And there was Randy Moss after a short pass and a drop. Lawrence Maroney going in for one of his 2 touchdowns. And the Patriots, 16-0, complete the regular season in a tremendous battle.
It looked like a playoff game last night, a great playoff game. And the Giants played them tough. But every time the Patriots have found themselves behind in the second half this year, they found a way to win the game. They did again last night.
First down for the Saints on the Bear 47. Brees looking to throw on first down. Pass incomplete. Intended for Marcus Colston. Time for a game break. Here's Kurt Menefee.
While you have NFC Pro Bowl returner Devin Hester in your game, Josh Cribbs is the man in the AFC, and here's why. A 76-yard punt return for a score. His 3rd return for a score this year. The other 2 on kickoffs. And Cleveland leads San Francisco 7-0 in that ball game. Back to Dick and Boldy.
And you know, Brian, that all the Browns care about is Tennessee losing today.
Yeah, if Tennessee loses against the Colts tonight, they will advance to the playoffs provided they win today.
Second down and 10 from the 47, and this pass floats and nearly picked off by McBride.
What we're seeing here from the New Orleans Saints is a team that is a dome team, a passing team. Here in the elements today, we're seeing drop passes. We're seeing some breakdowns with protection right now. And Drew Brees in this passing game struggling against a fired up Bears defense, a defense that has played exceedingly well in the last month.
Third down and 10. Saints had a golden opportunity starting this series in Bears territory. David Patton on the screen gets the first down for New Orleans. Ricky Manning on the stop, a gain of 11. And the Saints right now with their deepest penetration.
It was a good play here by Drew Brees and the Saints because they catch the Bears with a lot of guys up in the line of scrimmage, and they're just going to check it off. Just a little wide receiver screen, and that's all that's required there for David Patton. You can see Patton out here. Just a little wide receiver screen over the hands of Agunlia, and then he's got two blockers out front. Fain out there along with Jahri Evans leading the way.
Matt Tolina playing defensive tackle number 75. Jimmy Kennedy, number 72, also in there for Chicago. First down, Brees' pass and knocked away. And that pass was intended for Devery Henderson and the rookie Trumaine McBride, starting for Nathan Basher with a good play.
That's a very good play by Trumaine McBride because he stayed on the outside shoulder of Henderson, funneled him to the inside, and then was able to get the hand on the ball as he closed on the pass.
To no surprise, Brian, the Saints have passed 11 of their 14 plays so far in this first quarter.
He's thrown over 600 passes this year so far.
A record-breaking year for him, potentially. And here is Pierre Thomas. Busts outside, remains on his feet. Good run by Pierre Thomas. Manning making the tackle after an 8-yard gain.
Well, here's the strength of Pierre Thomas and the strong legs that he has. He prides himself in able to break tackles, stay in his balance, runs over Charles Tillman there. And if Daniel Manning doesn't come to finish him up, he may still be stumbling down the field.
Thomas beat out the Saints' fourth round pick, Antonio Pittman, in training camp. So he's earned his spot. That's what he's done thus far. Third down and two, Wallace. Gets hit as he throws, and it's knocked away. And a great play made by Brandon McGowan on Billy Miller, the tight end. So fourth down coming up. And it's fourth and two. And one of the things you said as we looked at this replay.
Great pass coverage. I mean, you can't defend it any better than McGowan does.
And it looks like the Saints are going for it on fourth down, which Sean Payton said he would do often in this one.
Yeah, he said, you know, fourth down, you have a 50-50 chance to make it here in fourth and less than three. And he likes putting the ball in Drew Brees' hands, and Brees likes that responsibility of going for it on fourth down.
Brees, and it's cut. And the Bears will take over on downs. Adewale Agunlia get his hands on it. So the fourth down gamble by Sean Payton, and the Bears will take over.
Well, here's Agunlia up top right here. All he's going to do is play this short slant route right here. He comes inside, gets his hands up, and the Bears in just the last three passes have tipped all three.
And a very aggressive Bears defense today. And take over on downs at the 28, and Garrett Wolf, the changeup running back, is in the lineup now, and Devin Hester is split wide right. And the quick going out to Hester. Puts the stiff arm on Jason Kraft, and a flag goes down, and the Bears may have a first down pending the call.
Personal foul.
Face mask, number 23, offense. 15-yard penalty, repeat first down.
There's the stiff arm here by Devin Hester. Right into the face mask of Jason Kraft, and he kept it on. Not only did he stiff arm on the face mask, but then he grabbed it and he didn't release it.
That'll nullify the first down.
Two things about Devin Hester. One, he came in last year and Lovie Smith just wanted to get him integrated in the return game. He came in as a cornerback. This year we're seeing the evolution of him in the offense and learning some of the things about playing receiver like that, not putting your hands into the face mask and grabbing it. And next year, I think we'll see him fully integrated in this offense and a big part of it.
And this team needs an improved offense, no question about it, and Hester will have a lot more responsibility. Lovie Smith promises. First down and 15. Garrett Wolf bounces off the defender, gets a few extra yards, and winds up at the 33. Kraft on the tackle, but Wolf gets 10 on that run.
It's just that time of the year around the league right now. You're looking at the third, the fourth, the fifth running back. We're looking at Pierre Thomas for the Saints today and Garrett Wolf, the third round pick of the Bears this year from Northern Illinois, who set all kinds of college rushing records. Hard guy to find back there, probably the smallest guy on the field. but has great quickness. And I think he could be a real asset in the screen game for the Bears going forward.
And, of course, the change of pace back with the speed, only 5'7". You mentioned the third-round pick. So, once again, they adjust the play clock, which is winding down to about a half a minute remaining in the first quarter. Second down and 5. Orton has that pass tipped, and that was Charles Grant who got a hand on it to bring up third down.
See, that last time when Kyle Orton had this ball tipped, the first thing he did is like following your shot in basketball. He went after it, trying to get that ball down. If anybody from the Saints might come down with it, he was going to go knock the ball down himself. That's the worst feeling for a quarterback, Dick, is when they get a pass tipped, because you never know the result of what the play could have been had the defender not, time to jump like that.
And a little unusual for the Bears, passing 12 times and rushing only 8. But they have the lead 10-0. Third down and 5. Good protection. And the pass thrown over the head of Bernard Berrien. And that will bring up fourth down with 18 seconds and 13 on the official clock remaining in the first.
When Kyle Orton has missed today, he's missed high on about 3 or 4 passes right now. And one of the things they're trying to do with Kyle, one of the things Ron Turner has worked with him on, is shortening his motion. Kind of a big windup. He wants to kind of shorten it and tighten it up. And that might stop the ball from sailing on him like it has in this game.
Orton is 4 for 13 for 43 yards and has a touchdown pass. Brad Maynard will be kicking to Lance Moore. And the ball bounding at the 35. And will be down there. So Chris Reese of the Saints got a hand on that one. Brian Urlacher, who has an interception in this game. And that is the end of the first quarter. With the score, the Bears 10 and the Saints nothing. Lovie Smith, who was the NFL Coach of the Year 2 years ago, and Sean Payton, who had that honor last year, leading their teams here as we start the second quarter, and the Bears leading the Saints 10-0. Dick Stockton along with Brian Baldinger. First and 10 for New Orleans. And a penalty flag down.
False start, number 12. Offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
That was the receiver, Marcus Colston, so 5 yards, so it'll send the Saints back to first and 15.
What you always have to ask yourself, Dick, is two teams that are on the outside looking in at the playoffs, just what the level of concentration is coming into the last game, especially if you're the road team. You see, everything is going to end later today.
On a slant, Colston, and he is tackled close to the first down by Danielle Manning. Game break, here's Kurt.
Packers have already clinched the number 2 seed in the NFC, and if you don't think they're having fun today against the Lions, watch Brett Favre. Touchdown pass after scrambling to Bubba Franks, but then how about the celebration? Referee Pete Morelli, give me 5, 10, 15, keep it going. 21-3 right now, Packers in the second. Dick and Baldy.
Big difference, Brian, from a week ago in this goal.
Boy, Brett, that didn't look like he said it was the worst conditions he's ever played in 16 years. Green Bay here at Soldier Field last week. There's a Colston record there with that last catch.
Brees, and he completes it to Colston. And Colston with a first down inside the 40 to add to his record. 18 yards on the play to Marcus Colston. And Sean Payton likes to say, if we knew he was going to be that good, we wouldn't have waited to the seventh round last year.
The seventh round, yeah. In fact, he was so good so early that they traded away Dante Stallworth last year to the Eagles during training camp, and started making way for him to emerge in this offense.
Stallworth, of course, now with the Patriots. The pitch going to Pierre Thomas on the outside has running room. And Thomas getting inside the 30, and the Saints may have yet another first down with Brandon McGowan, the strong safety, chasing.
Well, it's a big afternoon for Pierre Thomas. He said he had 70 fans of friends, family that wanted to come to the game.
How many tickets did he get?
Purchase 10, because he already knows, you know, I mean, you're week 17 in the NFL. You're a veteran now. You know that you're not getting the money back from your family and friends if you buy their tickets.
And you know he's not a high-priced guy yet anyway, so that's a lot of tickets to buy. We're going to have a measurement to see whether the Saints did pick up the first down. Of course, in the championship game last year, here at Soldier Field, the Bears won it 39-14. And it is a first down for New Orleans, but the Saints had an early deficit in that one.
Well, they were down 16-0 in this NFC Championship game right here a year ago, January 19th at Soldier Field. They got back into the game 16-14. In fact, they missed a field goal that could have put them up in that game 17-16. And then, you know, they had a safety against them, and it sort of tumbled backwards from there. But they got back into the game a year ago.
But a big difference to this season. And the Saints needing to win and need help if they're to make the playoffs. In motion is Terrence Copper. And on the screen pass, here's Pierre Thomas. And Thomas trying to grind and get to the first down and may have another one. So what a debut here at Soldier Field for Pierre Thomas. From 28 miles south of here.
Well, he looks like he belongs. I mean, he does a great job of setting up the screen, inviting Hillemeyer up. And now, this is what he does best. He's got great bounce. We talked about the strength in his legs. He spends a lot of time in a weight room just building him up. And you can see he's breaking tackles. And the other key ingredient, he's got great bounce. It's hard to knock him off those strong legs.
Doing the job. Aaron Stecker's been in the lineup but hasn't carried it yet. Here is Brees with the pass through the hands of Marcus Colston. Incomplete. And that will bring up third and one.
Well, this is the area of offense where the Saints have struggled. On third and short, goal line situations where in years past, you just hand the ball off to Deuce McAllister and he gets you the first down. You stay on schedule. You stay on the field. They have had problems converting these situations this year.
And Reggie Bush, when he took over from McAllister, not quite the lead running back that Deuce was. Third down and one. And a play fake, pressure from the secondary, and that does the job for the Bears. The pass intended for Thomas, incomplete. And it was Brandon McGowan who stormed in on Drew Brees.
There comes the pressure, and this is what the Saints are forced to do in a lot of these situations, is throw the ball on third and inches simply because they don't trust that they have a back powerful enough to go carry it right into the pile.
So it'll be fourth and less than one. And once again, the Saints trying for the first down. They were stymied the first time they went for it on fourth down and two. And here's Thomas, and he'll get the first down running straight ahead as he is tackled at the 17, a gain of four.
See, I think Sean Payton has to trust Pierre Thomas. What he's shown here is great strength and power. And give it to him in those short yardage situations. Last week they had a goal line stand. The Eagles stopped him down on the 1 foot yard line. He couldn't score on four running attempts right into the belly of the Eagles defense. Really turned that game around. The Eagles then took the ball 98 yards and there was a 14 point turnaround which affected the outcome of the game last week.
First down on the 17 of the Bears. And the quick to Moore. And Moore is wrestled down immediately by McBride. Seventh round pick from Ole Miss and a 1 yard pickup.
Just looking at the Saints roster with Lance Moore going out, he was a free agent. Marcus Colston, a seventh round pick. Pierre Thomas, a free agent. I think Sean Payton looks at these guys and says, you know, they give it everything they've got. Plus, they've got some talent. And Robert Meacham, the first round pick, not active. Lance Moore in there. To Sean Payton's credit, he's playing the players that give him the best chance to win.
I'm playing the drive. Second and nine. Brees will swing it out to Thomas. And Thomas getting inside the 10-yard line. And another first down. Very effective in this first quarter and early in the second, Pierre Thomas.
Well, here's Urlacher here. And he's going to get picked off by the right tackle right here. You're going to see Stinchcomb come out. And he locks up on Urlacher here. And now Pierre Thomas does a good job of running right off of that block, which allowed him to get the first down. And Pierre Thomas here, really valuable. Short yardage on third, on fourth and inches in the receiving game, and also running the ball.
And already 55 total yards. And averaging 6.3 yards per carry. First and goal, going to the hot hand and getting inside the five is Thomas. And it'll be second down and goal as the Saints, with their best offensive threat of the game.
Look at Pierre Thomas and Sean Payton calling the play there. And when they drafted Reggie Bush with the second pick last year, they automatically thought that he would be able to handle this part of a football game, the inside running, and he just doesn't have that type of power. He doesn't carry people. He doesn't push the pile the way this kid does, the way Deuce McAllister did, and I think it opened a lot of eyes to just what type of player Reggie Bush is.
Posted to the top of your picture, and the pass intended for him gets knocked down, and it was Alex Brown who deflected it, and it looked like the Bears knew exactly what was coming on that play.
Well, Alex Brown has played really well in the last couple weeks. Mark Anderson hurt, out for the year on injured reserve, one of 13 Chicago Bears on injured reserve, and you've seen a lot of passes batted down from Drew Brees today by these Bears.
Drew Brees not been sacked in the red zone, nor has he thrown an interception in the red zone.
Chris Colston.
And a great job of ball control. Third down and goal. And Brees with time fires it fifth. He wanted to go to Colston, and the flag comes down. And McGowan, the strong safety defending. And let's see if that call goes against Chicago.
Pass interference. Number 36, defense. Hook the right receiver around the waist. Ballinger in the end zone. All these places to one. First down.
Well, here's McGowan in the back. Just turning it over to him. I don't know. I mean, you know, the right hand was on the hip of Marcus Colston, and they shouldn't throw that flag unless he turns Marcus Colston. I think he just rested it there and defended the ball with his left hand.
First and goal. Hand off to Thomas, and he's knocked back. The Bears were ready for him as Lance Briggs, and slow to get up, is the first man there. So Lance Briggs, and question as to whether he will be with the Bears next year. Unrestricted free agent. Second down and goal coming up.
You know, Lovie Smith would love to have Lance Briggs back. We'd love to keep that combination of him and Urlacher at linebacker.
They have eight free agents. Can't keep them all. And here is Thomas going outside and tripped up. And Lance Briggs with back-to-back plays stopping the Saints as they try to run it in. And that will bring up third and goal.
Well, last week, Sean Payton, we talked about it, had a first and goal at the 1 foot line. And he said, we're not going to get cute. We're going to run the ball. They did four times in a row, and they lost yards on every carry. So far here, with first and goal at the foot line, they've done the same thing.
And a timeout. 8:40 remaining in the second. Timeout, New Orleans. Saints calling their first timeout of this first half. Have a third down and goal from the three. Marcus Colston split to the left. And Charles Tillman has been with him all the way. And there is a fade pattern to Colston. Comes down with a touchdown, Saints, as they get back in the game.
Well, they put Charles Tillman out there, their best defender. And you cannot throw a fade route any better than Brees did. It goes back shoulder to Marcus Colston, and then it's also high at the same time. It's away from Tillman. You see Tillman's got his hand in a perfect position to strip that ball out. But Colston, as tall and strong as he is, great ball by Brees, and then a great catch by Colston.
10th touchdown catch of the year for Colston. And Martin Gramatica with the extra point, and the Saints jump back in this one. Remember, Sean Payton's team needs to win and then hope the Redskins and the Vikings lose later on. And the Saints jump back in this on the perfectly thrown fade to Marcus Colston from 3 yards out. 26 touchdown pass by Drew Brees. And the 67-yard scoring drive chews up 6.5 minutes.
Bears are anticipating an onside kick here. Instead, they pooch kick it.
And coming up is Devin Hester on the run on a short kick. But the Saints don't let him get away. That's like the worst case scenario is a short kick with Hester on the run. Returns this 12 yards. Marvin Mitchell made the stop.
Going back to the touchdown of Marcus Colston. You see just a great fade route right here. Just see it again. Brees really pushes out of his hands away from Colston. But in pregame warm-up, Colston's a true pro. I mean, he spends a lot of his time down there before every game working the sidelines. Because the receiver has to know where he's at on the field without ever looking to be able to get both feet in bounds. He practices those kind of things. Just a diligent guy.
First down, and he gives to Adrian Peterson. Cutting outside. Peterson with a big gain in the Saints territory to the 43-yard line. A 20-yard run on first down and a great block by the tight end, Desmond Clark.
Watch the block here by Jason McKee leading the way. Fullback does a good job leading on the middle linebacker right there. And then Adrian Peterson, patient, right behind him, makes the cut right off of McKee's block. Then Musa Muhammad downfield does a good job. I mean, everybody wants to get on the act when the running game is rolling.
First down on the 43 of the Saints. Peterson fighting his way inside the 40. Peterson has averaged about 6 yards a carry, so the unheralded running backs getting the job done for both teams in this first half.
You know, and this is a disappointing season for the Bears. We've put up the statistics, how they run the ball, and if you want to be a running team, you've got to run it better than the Bears have throughout the course of the year. And so Lovie Smith is not going to change the way that he wants to win games. The running game is always going to be the foundation. Adrian Peterson has been a part of it.
Bobble on the snap, and Orton will cover up. And a flag will be thrown by Bill Levy, the referee.
Personal foul, number 91, defense. Unnecessary roughness, hitting the quarterback on the ground.
Will Smith with his second unnecessary roughness penalty of the game.
It's Will Smith at right end. He comes inside on a twist stunt. Orton laying down. The ball is dead right there.
Totally unnecessary.
Yep. This has been a disciplined defense all year. I mean, that's only their fourth personal foul all season. No roughing calls on the quarterback and only two pass interference calls. So very unlike the Saints this season.
Peterson up the middle and a strong run. Scott Shanley was the first to get to Peterson, who picks up nearly 5 yards.
Just looking at the way the Bears are controlling the line of scrimmage here in the running game. And it's important to the Bears to win these last couple of games. Lovie Smith believes, just like the Packers did last year when they won their last four, and it was a springboard to this year's success, that momentum can carry over in the offseason.
He said, we're very close, and he says there's not one game this year that we trailed by more than a touchdown going into the fourth quarter. So the Bears have been in every one. Second down and six, Orton's throw, and knocked down, and Berrien defended by Jason Kraft, and that was a close call for Orton and the Bears.
That was inches away from a pick six. And this is what you have to think about when you're evaluating Kyle Orton. This is a long throw from the far hash to the sidelines and a really quick corner that you would see in the playoffs. And Asante Samuel in New England will take that ball and go to the house. He'll make that break. That ball was too slow and too well telegraphed in getting to the receiver.
Devin Hester to the top of your picture. The Bears will call a timeout. It'll be their second timeout of this first half. Bears up 10-7. We'll be right back. 6:13 remaining in the first half. The day started in sunshine and it's been overcast since. And since Orton threw his touchdown pass to Mark Bradley in the first quarter, he's 0-5.
Devin Hester down here with the left flanker position.
Orton looking right all the way. Completes the pass to Musin Muhammad. First catch of the game for Muhammad inside the 10-yard line, picking up 15.
Now this is a great throw. I mean, here's Musin Muhammad right here working against Usama Young in the slot. Gets some leverage there, puts that left foot in the ground, and then turns, and the ball is perfectly thrown. That's a throw that might be the best throw that Kyle Orton has made all day. and a key spot converting that third down.
So shortly after that risky pass out to the flat, he drills this one, and there's the pitch to Peterson. Peterson is going to throw it wide open, burying, touchdown. Score and a little slipping and sliding and all the way, but the Bears will take it.
Watch the creativity in this play, and it's all because Adrian Peterson, he sells the run. You can't sell the run any better than that right there, and then you have to honor that. Jason Kraft is out there. You have to honor that this might be a run, and as soon as he flinches to come forward, Adrian Peterson brought the defense to him and then just flipped it to Davis.
Robbie Gould adding the 17th point for the Bears, are up 17-7. And kind of an unorthodox throw to the right, but Peterson gets it done. And Berrien on the receiving end. Adrian Peterson as a thrower, finding Berrien, the leading receiver for the Bears this year, with his fifth touchdown catch of the season. And Chicago opens up a 10-point lead, 7 plays, 63 yards. And the Bears did it under 3 minutes as Gould with a line drive kickoff to Chris Barkley. And Barkley holding on to the ball, brings it out to the 31. Adam Archuleta making the stop. Well, 2 weeks from tonight on Fox, it's the series premiere of Terminator, the Sarah Connor Chronicles. The machines are back, and only a mother's love for her son can save the future. Terminator, the Sarah Connor Chronicles, premieres 2 weeks from tonight on Fox. Viewer discretion is advised. So the Bears looking to put back-to-back wins for the first time this year. Amazing. A team goes to a Super Bowl, and they're trying to win back-to-back games on the final two outings of the year. Drew Brees, first down. Saints trying to come back here. The pass up the middle, caught by Colston, shy of midfield. And a gain of 16. And the hurry up offense here as slows down now. Coming into the game is Terrence Copper in his fourth year. And Marcus Colston thus far has caught 5 passes for 59 yards, including a touchdown grab. Sideline, defended by Brian Urlacher.
Bears defense today has been active throughout, and they've gotten to Brees early. Urlacher with his fourth interception in the last 5 games. Goulier gets Brees down. They've defended the pass well. Held the Saints here to 1 touchdown in the first half. So just really a good collective team effort, and that guy calling the signals, been in the middle of it all.
Second down and 2 after the 7-yard gain. Copper moving in motion to the left. And Drew Brees fires. And the pass is incomplete. Intended for Eric Johnson. And good coverage by Trumaine McBride.
I think one of the things that have bothered the Saints last year in the playoff loss, and then already today, is Urlacher coming? Isn't he coming? When he's up in that line of scrimmage, sometimes he does, sometimes he bluffs. Sometimes he backs off to intercept the pass. It really affects the protection when the quarterback is right underneath the center. Forces you almost to go shotgun every play, which the Saints don't want to do.
Brees, 11 of 23, passing for 100 yards. Here is Thomas. He gets the first down with some running room off the left side and carries it to about the 32, getting 11 yards before Danielle Manning, the free safety, takes him down.
Pierre Thomas coming into today on limited carries has averaged almost 5 yards a carry. He's doing that almost today as well, and you can see that he's a patient runner. He can break tackles. He runs low to the ground behind his pads. He looks like an NFL running back out there.
Most carries he's had in any game was 12, and that was against the Carolina Panthers, and he was very impressive in that game. You mentioned powerful legs. First down. Brees pump fakes one way and goes underneath to Mike Carney, the fullback. And Carney gets 5 yards with 3.5 minutes remaining in the first half. As you look at the rushing average, impressive for both teams, with Peterson and Thomas doing the job respectively. Saints started the year losing their first 4 games and losing Deuce McAllister. Won their next 4 and then kind of struggled along the way. It looked like they were making a move before they lost to Tampa Bay at home in a big loss and then last week to the Eagles. And there is Thomas, and Thomas's extra effort will get him the first down. Very impressive drive runner today is Pierre Thomas, who picks up 7 more.
Now he's motivated and inspired today playing on his first visit to Soldier Field. You can see that. Runs right through Tremaine McBride, runs through McGowan and Urlacher, and finally Manning, with a lot of help, is able to get him down to the ground. I don't think we've seen him carry the ball today where he hasn't broken at least one tackle.
But it's been an uphill climb for the Saints in this first half. They've been trailing all the way and trying to get closer before an intermission. Down by 10. Here's Drew Brees, and trying to get it to Billy Miller. Incomplete.
Brees would like to have that one back, Dick. He'd like to have that back. He got exactly what he wanted. He got the play action fake there. He got Miller behind the defense with a great chance to get it into the end zone, and he missed it.
Saints coming into the game 3rd in the NFL in passing, 28th in rushing. They have averaged over 5 yards a rush. So that's been working for them today. Here's the 8th play of this drive. From the 21. They fake the run. Brees completes to Colston. Colston at the 5. Touchdown. Marcus Colston. And Drew Brees got rid of it just before he was hit from behind. A 21-yard pass, and the Saints come back again.
Brees was just able to hold on to this ball just long enough for Colston here to come inside and then come back out. Took a long time for this to happen. Sits down in the zone, and now the Bears lost him because there was so much time. That was about a 4-second play that Brees had the ball. Give credit to the offensive line. Colston gets his 2nd touchdown of the day.
And Martin Gramatica looking to bring the Saints to within 3. And he does, with 2:07 remaining. So Drew Brees with his 2nd touchdown pass, 2nd to Marcus Colston, the familiar target. And the game becomes tight once again.
Well, Drew Brees said, you know, he's just an incredible target, and you can always find him. And as you look, take a look at Drew Brees and his offense today, 2 touchdown drives. He's had an incredible season, 2nd incredible season for the Saints. They make every throw, attempted more passes than any quarterback in the league coming into today.
And he has tied the record for most completions in a season. Rich Gannon, back in 2002, completed 418. And the scoring drive, 8 plays, 69 yards. And Colston having another big year. What a big acquisition Drew Brees was. And there was some thought that he might go to Miami, but Sean Payton and the New Orleans Saints really wooed him and said, we don't know what your physical condition is, but we want you here.
And coming off a shoulder surgery, final game injured a couple years ago. His wife is a native of Chicago, so she's in the audience here today.
And here is the low grounder kick. Devin Hester will pick it up, and he is upended at the 36. But the plan not to have Devin Hester touch the ball on returns has gone awry for the Saints today.
But the coverage has been good. They haven't let him get loose there. The pooch kick right there, squib right up the middle. Good coverage by Terrence Copper. So while it's not perfect in Sean Payton's eyes, the results have been very good.
So Orton going back to work. And the Saints doing a lot better defensively than they did a week ago, as you look at Orton's numbered when they gave up 435 yards in total offense to the Eagles. A more prolific team on the attack than the Bears. Orton with time and finds Muhammad, who goes out of bounds, stops the clock. about 2 yards shy of the first down. And with 1:57 to go, the 8-yard pickup brings up our 2-minute warning here at Soldier Field in Chicago with the Bears up by 3. Well, they call it the second city, but I don't think Chicago takes a backseat to anything as Orton, with 2 minutes remaining, going deep for Hester, makes the catch and scores. Yards, and you knew sooner or later the swift Devin Hester would get open. And the Bears come back quickly.
Well, he scores a touchdown about every one out of about 10 times he touches it. You can only keep him down so long, and this has been a play that really they haven't run enough of this year. Just a straight fly pattern. Streak pattern, gets behind the safety. Josh Bullock's there. Good hands, able bringing it to the end zone, and what a remarkable talent he is, and has to be a bigger part of this offense come next season.
Robbie Gould makes it 24-14. So Devin Hester, who caught an 81-yard touchdown pass from Brian Greasy against the Vikings in week 6. This 55 yards, and once again the Bears up by 10. Coming up on the Visa halftime report, Kirk, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy will have scores and highlights from around the league, and the Fox Sports ticker has up to the second scores and stats. And you know, there's a lot of talk late in the year about teams resting their players. You know, the Saints aren't, because they have a shot at the playoffs. But after watching the Patriots and the Giants last night, and a lot of the football, this is what the NFL is all about, really, playing the full 16-game schedule, whether you're winner, loser, going to the playoffs or not.
I don't really agree with resting players. I believe you got to stay sharp every week. You're used to playing every 7 days and playing out the schedule. And the Bears here today, with no playoffs on the horizon this year, giving it everything they've got, giving the fans something to get excited about, showing things that they can build upon come next season. And Devin Hester, I mean, it doesn't get any easier than that. Drop back and throw it as far as you can. Let Hester run underneath it. To me, it should have been a staple of this playbook all season long.
And, of course, you have to be on the inside to know how much he really has to learn as a receiver and some of those mechanical things. I know fans can get impatient, but you'll see more of him in that role. Terrence Copper returning the kick. And Copper finally going out of bounds. With 1:39 to go, the Saints have 2 timeouts remaining. And the Saints needing a victory. And they don't have to do any scoreboard watching, because the Redskins and the Cowboys on Fox coming up next. And, of course, the Minnesota Vikings against Denver. The Saints have to end up on top. They trail by 10 and hope those other two teams lose, Washington and Minnesota. First down from the 34. Pass is tipped. Incomplete, intended for Colston. So Colston had a chance to grab that one, even though it was tipped at the line.
He actually dropped it before Manning got to it. Both teams are aggressive right now in the passing game. You got to give the Bears a lot of credit. They've opened up this offense for Kyle Orton. They've taken advantage of it, taking a shot down to Hester, and I would expect Brees to be just as aggressive here with still 2 timeouts to go.
And a game of 2 former Purdue quarterbacks. Orton and Brees, who now steps up, and his pass low to Colston once again, and quickly 3rd and 10.
In fact, Drew Brees is the one that showed Kyle Orton around when he came to Purdue for his visit coming out of high school. Brees does a great job of avoiding pressure. Came in today with only being sacked 13 times in almost 600 attempts. The fewest anybody's been sacked in the year. The season this year. 1 sack today, so 14 on the year.
3rd down and 10. Minute and a half to go. Bears looking to get the ball back, perhaps, and this ball is caught by Colston, and they're trying to wrestle it away from him. It's an 8-yard pickup. Was Danielle Manning. And Drew Brees has set an NFL single season record with his 419th pass completion.
And the chance to get number 420 right here on this fourth down, their third time that they've gone for it aggressively on fourth down today.
And they're doing it in their own territory. From the 42-yard line.
Look for Colston on this play.
And Saints will call a timeout.
New Orleans. That's their second charge timeout. 30-second timeout.
So they've got one left. If you're going to call one when you have fourth down in the enemy territory. Coming up, Visa Halftime Report, or your own, that is. Kurt Terry, Howie, and Jimmy scores and highlights in the Fox Sports ticker. Again, we want to remind you, coming up next, it will be the Cowboys and the Redskins in that great rivalry. And Cowboys would like nothing better than to beat the Redskins and knock them out of the playoffs.
And I think, as Olin Krutz and his quarterback Kyle Orton talk about things, the Saints have done the same thing and rethought going for it in Bears territory on fourth and two.
Well, that's the aggressive stance that Sean Payton said he would take in this game, and now they are going to kick it away as Weatherford will be punting and Devin Hester goes back. So not taking that big of a chance is Payton, and kicking toward the sideline and out of bounds. 37 seconds remain in the first half and the Bears have one timeout remaining. And the way New Orleans has come back and hit some big scores when they were down by 10. They're looking to stop Chicago here. Well, next Sunday, the NFL's second season begins as the NFC's best teams go head-to-head to see which two have the drive, determination, and desire to advance to the championship game. Coverage of the NFC playoffs begins next Sunday with the wild card in high definition. Only on Fox.
And here's Devin Hester down at the bottom and Bernard Behring up top. I mean, I drop back and throw down the field again.
And they loft this one to Peterson. And Peterson has a touchdown. Pass for a score, losing the ball on the football on the play, and the Saints get it back. So Peterson fumbles after the run after the catch, and New Orleans will get it back, and Antoine Lake, the defensive tackle, picks it up.
See, Scott Shanley comes in from behind and rips that ball out. Take that right hand as he was going to the ground and pulled that ball right out there.
And Lake said, look what I found. So 26 seconds left. The Saints still have one timeout left.
Saints want to hurry up and try to get this playoff before this has a chance of being reviewed.
And this is a booth review, but the decision will be made by the referee Bill Levy, as each team has now turned it over once in the game. We'll take a break, return in a moment. We're back, a booth review, Bill Levy.
After reviewing the play, the runner lost the ball before his knee was down. It is a fumble. First down, New Orleans.
And that will cost the Bears the timeout.
Here's Scott Shanley from behind. That ball now is out right there. The legs have not hit the ground yet, so it was a good call. Easy review. The Saints here with 26 seconds left.
Have
and
the
a
ball
timeout
on the 29-yard line. So this has been a game in which the Bears have led all the way, but the Saints have come back on two occasions trying to make it three before intermission.
Colston against a zone look here. We'll have room to catch this ball.
Good pass to Colston. He gets hit but holds on to it. And a crunching hit by Danielle Manning. And a timeout called immediately, and that is the last timeout by the Saints with 17 seconds left. So they got 6 yards.
Watch this. This is actually a trap to Colston here. They're going to come up here, and then Urlacher is going to come out to him here. and try to sandwich him on this throw. If that ball was thrown inside, Urlacher was going to whack him. They throw it more down the seam, and that's Manning there to throw to hit him.
Hostin, who had a chest contusion, as you mentioned last week against the Eagles, didn't return to the game, has caught 8 passes for 94 yards, 2 touchdown receptions, but he's paid for it.
He has, but that's part of why you like big receivers like he is a big body, 220 pounds. He's gone as high as 235. He said he was too slow then. But a big wide body like that can take the punishment from these guys.
No timeouts left for the Saints. It'll be 2nd down and 4.
You still have time here, Dick, to throw the ball in the field of play and get up and clock the ball if should you catch it and stop the clock.
Brees with a pump fake. And going for David Patton. Incomplete in the corner of the end zone. 14 seconds remain. McBride on the coverage. And David Patton running all the way through the tunnel that time. Welcome back, David.
Receivers are used to retrieving their own overthrown footballs right there. Had a great chance to get that ball into David Patton there for the touch. Got behind McBride. Brees is very good in these situations at knowing the clock, the situation, where they can go with the ball on third down here.
Clock a big factor here, and Brees is passed, and it's intercepted by Charles Tillman, returning for the Bears, and he fumbles it, and the Saints get it back. Watch the clock, and it stops with 2 seconds remaining. Back on the 30-yard line, a bizarre series of an interception and a fumble. Lance Moore recovered it here.
Brees really tried to force this ball into Lance Moore. Great play by Charles Tillman. Now, Tillman's trying to score here. Trying to get, and he just dropped the ball, it looked like. Looked like the ball just fell out of his hands. Tillman does a good job of playing. That's a cover two right there. The corner falls off, squeezes him to the safety. Oh, yeah, that ball got stripped out by Pierre Thomas there. Knocked out of his hands, and now the Saints with a chance for a field goal.
And it's going to be a 48-yard attempt. Martin Gramatica, who tied a career high last week with a 55-yarder. 2 seconds remain in the first half. And Gramatica's kick is good. So the interception and ensuing fumble by Tillman, and Gramatica, as he likes to do, celebrates after the field goal, and a big one. And that is the end of the first half with the score. The Bears 24, the Saints 17. The Visa Halftime Report coming right up. Saints looking to get into the playoffs, and the Bears trying to finish strong. And it's 24-17, and the Saints keep coming back in this game, Brian.
Well, you know, they don't want it to end. You know, they want it to go into next week in the wild card week, and they need help later today. But in the Bears, they were trying to string their first two-game win streak together, and they're hitting and playing as hard as they can out there. It was a great first half. Can't wait for the second one here to begin.
And Chris Barkley returning the second half kickoff for New Orleans, but good coverage by the Bears, and he's buried at the 15-yard line. Let's take a look at the first half summary as Drew Brees setting an NFL single-season record for completions. Pierre Thomas, in his first game ever, grew up right near Chicago, 28 miles, 64 yards. Marcus Colston now with the record for most receptions in a season, breaking Joe Horn's record. Kyle Orton's numbers, 2 touchdowns. Devin Hester has a TD catch as well. And a first down from the 15. Thomas with the carry. And gets a couple of yards as we get down on the field, and a report from Mike Hall.
Dick, I talked with Lovie Smith at halftime. He said the thing they want to fix most going into the second half is cut down on mistakes, saying that fumble at the end of the first half killed us. As for the New Orleans Saints, in the middle of halftime, Marcus Colston was the only player to come out of the locker room, got in a cart, and went away. I'll find out exactly what that is, but no word as of right now.
All right, Mike, thank you very much. Colston with 8 catches for 94 yards and 2 touchdowns. He's the big weapon along with Drew Brees today. And David Patton, number 81, has replaced him at wide receiver. Eric Johnson in motion. Play action for Brees. The ball knocked away. And the Saints appear to have recovered. Alex Brown knocked it away. And Jari Evans recovered for New Orleans.
Well, here's Alex Brown working against Jamal Brown down here. And Alex Brown is playing like he wants to be back here next year, wants to start again someplace next year, making a lot of impactful plays the last 2 weeks.
This is only his second start. Prior to this year, he started the Super Bowl. Mark Anderson went on IR with a sprained knee, and people have wondered why hasn't Alex Brown been there as a starter before the last couple of weeks. Third down and 10. Brees on the screen to Thomas, and he's taken down immediately by Tommy Harris, number 91. No gain on the play.
And Tommy Harris, we just haven't not called his name enough this year. He's been bothered by injuries going all the way back to last year with the hamstring injury, missing the Super Bowl, and then coming in this year having a knee injury that set him back in and out of the lineup for weeks. But when he's on and he's healthy, this can be a special defense.
And you saw Devin Hester go back deep, and Steve Weatherford, who's had a terrific season punting for the Saints, will be kicking from about the 5. Hester, listen to the anticipation of this crowd. Hester at the 40, and Hester is going to go all the way. No flags are down. Devin Hester. A punt return, touchdown, 64 yards. His fourth of the year. Bears increase their lead.
Dick, you said it. There was a hush in the audience, like, here we go. He could, and he's gone. I mean, you just hold your breath. Sean Payton said, we can't kick to this guy today. They have, and they now just paid for it.
And you could sense it in the audience before the ball even came down.
No question. Just it's that feeling of it's been a while, we haven't seen it, and here it is, and here he goes.
Robbie Gould looking to give the Bears a 31-17 lead. And the kick is good. 35 points last week against Green Bay. 31 today. Devin Hester's 11th regular season return of a kick or punt for a touchdown in his brief career.
Today's game is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. With Southwest Airlines' convenient nonstop flights, it's like having your own company plane. By Budweiser, reach for the perfect balance of flavor and refreshment. Budweiser, the great American lager. By Ford. And by Walmart. Save money, live better. Walmart.
And Soldier Field is an arena of celebration here. Devin Hester returning the punt 64 yards for a touchdown. His second touchdown of the game. The first was as a receiver. And it's 31-17 in favor of the Bears. Barkley returning for the Saints. And a pretty good return for Chris Barkley as he brings it out to midfield. And a flag is down back at the 20-yard line.
Holding, number 51, receiving team, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Brian Simmons called for holding, and they'll bring this one way back.
Let's take a look here at Devin Hester's return for a touchdown off the punt return. You're going to see that not a whole lot of blocks. Rasheed Davis gets one. I mean, this is Devin Hester, just the most dangerous guy in. Sean Payton shaking his head here, yelling at a special team coach, John Bonamago, yelling at Steve Weatherford, the punter. Came into our meeting. The first thing he said to us yesterday was, we are not going to let Devin Hester touch the ball in this game. And he's touched it 2 big times for touchdowns.
Now the Saints looking for Marcus Colston to touch it. First Thomas with the screen pass and a first down. Daniel Manning takes him out. And there was question about Marcus Colston from Mike Hall down on the field, but he was out on that first play from scrimmage. Meanwhile, 17 yards gets the Saints out of trouble.
Devin Hester, not only when he touches the ball is he the most dangerous guy in the league, but when he doesn't touch it, he influences what every team does in this league. Do we kick to him? Do we pooch punt to him? Do we pooch kickoff? Kick it out of bounds? Onside kick? It affects every single play in the kicking game when he's out there.
First down at the 29. Play action for Brees. And Brees going to Thomas. And the rookie from the University of Illinois making the most of his big chance here, coming back home to Chicago, picks up 15 more. Hillenmeyer, the linebacker, downfield on the stop.
Well, the game is not too big for Pierre Thomas.
No.
He looks like he just belongs out there. Every time he puts it in his hands, he makes good things happen to him.
Look at Aaron Stecker. You look at the Green Bay running attack. Look at Ernest Graham.
Yeah, Ryan Grant and Green Bay, all these free agent running backs making a huge impact in this league this year.
Graham, of course, from Tampa Bay, on the pitch to Pierre Thomas. Look at Thomas as he churns into Chicago territory to the 49, getting 8 yards.
He was almost choked up yesterday when he talked to us about what impact Deuce McAllister had, Reggie Bush had with him this year, Aaron Stecker, those guys in the room, that running back room, he said, were so special. And you got to give this guy credit. I mean, he came to a team that was loaded at running back. McAllister, Bush, Stecker. They had drafted Antonio Pittman from Ohio State, yet he thought he could still earn his stripes in this league on this team.
Chris Barkley is now at running back. And the pass incomplete for Moore, and a flag goes down, and the Bears complaining over that possible interference call, which would give the Saints the first down.
Pass interference, number 33 defense. First down, spot of the foul.
Tillman, the penalty.
Tillman playing an outside technique here on Lance Moore, funneling him to the inside. Well, the initial hit inside 5 yards, contact there was all legal, and then he got his hands off him. I thought in time to not allow that infraction to occur.
First down at the 43. Thomas back in the lineup. Brees, nowhere to go, finds a receiver, and it's Eric Johnson. And the tight end, who was inactive the last two games with an injured groin, comes within 2 yards of the first down.
Well, Drew Brees, I think, always feels like he's got some place to go.
Yes.
I mean, that just staying in that pocket, knowing that it's collapsing around him, but keeping his eyes up down the field and then scanning to find, you know, an open receiver like that where Johnson came available.
7-yard pickup. So the Saints trying to get in the playoffs. Loss of Deuce McAllister. Major loss in week 3, taking away that aspect of their game. And on the rollout, pass to Billy Miller on the bootleg, but Miller will have the first down. And a pickup of 5 yards. So the Saints, who are down 31-17, their biggest deficit of the game with under 9.5 to go in the third, have a first down on the Bears 31.
Well, I think anytime you've got a quarterback like Brees that is accurate, that understands the game and where to go with the ball, you always have a chance. You're always going to get first downs. You're going to move the ball. He's going to do a good job of taking care of the ball. There's the distribution there. Colston with 8 of those 11 catches. His primary target, been in and out of the lineup, a little shaken up here in the second half.
False start. Number 44 offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
So Mark Carney, 5-yard penalty, and penalties also helped do in the Saints last week against the Philadelphia Eagles. This has been nothing near like their year of last season when they played the Bears in the NFC title game. Everything went their way, but despite the fact that they shot themselves in the foot with losses to Tampa Bay, game that they seemingly had in their pocket leading by 3 in the fourth quarter, and the last week to the Eagles, well, they're still alive. First and 15. Thomas. And not much. The Bears are right there.
You know, the way this whole schedule fell today, Dick, for the New Orleans Saints, I think the best thing that's happened for them, now they're still down 2 touchdowns. They got a long way to go here to get back in this thing and have a chance to win. But the fact that the Vikings play later today and that the Redskins play later today, they're not busy looking up the scoreboard, what happened. You know, they can play it, play to win it, and then let fate determine what happens in the later games today.
Just pay attention to the job at hand. Second down and 13. Brees in the pocket, and the pass is complete to Terrence Copper. And the Copper is down at the 25 by Hunter Hillenmeyer after picking up 9.
The Saints do a good job of protecting. And the Bears, who blitzed an awful lot last week, haven't come with it as much here today. Kind of like laying off and playing coverage, especially with this 14-point lead right now. I think they're afraid of blitzing Drew Brees because of he can hit you with, you know, strikeability on any single play.
And they have said that the Bears blitz a lot more at home.
Yeah, Lovie Smith told us that on yesterday morning.
4 for 4 on this drive is Drew Brees looking for the target, and it's knocked in the air. Incomplete. Alex Brown deflected that one. So fourth down coming up. It'll be fourth down and 4.
Well, they blitz this time. Both Briggs and Urlacher right up in the A gaps. See what they got. They got Tommy Harris on Mike Carney. Pretty good collision there. Harris ran him over. And this is that situation in the game that Sean Payton said that they're going to stay aggressive fourth here. And less than 5, put the ball in Drew Brees' hands and take their chances. The fourth time today, they've gone for it on fourth down.
1 for 2 thus far on the fourth down conversions. This is the longest that they've had to make 4 yards. And here is Brees, and the pass thrown behind David Patton. So Sean Payton playing it aggressively, fourth down, and the Bears will take over on downs. Once again, stymieing the New Orleans offense, and there is Sean Payton a little upset on the sideline. 7:07 remaining in the third quarter. 31-17, Chicago. Bears taking over at the 25 after stopping the Saints on fourth down. Adrian Peterson gets running room up the middle and gets 8 yards on first down.
It did go back to this last fourth down play. Bears are, again, a couple times today. They blitz these A-gaps, but they're getting their hands up on the outside. This ball gets slightly deflected. So it's behind David Patton there, and one thing that Sean Payton did during that timeout was he ran over to his offensive line. He told his guys, cut these guys, get their hands down, stop them from batting down these balls on these short routes.
Israel Adonijay has been made a career this season out of getting pieces. Here's a long pass to Bradley downfield. Bradley is there to make the catch. And did not keep control of the ball. The official was right there. Bradley came down with it, but did not have control when he reached the ground.
Well, the Bears wait to the 16th game of the season to unleash this deep passing game of theirs. Can't throw the ball any better than Kyle Orton did right there, and Bradley doesn't do a good job of taking this one all the way in. You see the ball slip through there. Good call by the side judge, seeing that ball slip through and hit the ground, but a great throw by Orton.
Would have been a 53-yard completion. Instead, third down and 2 with 6:22 to go in the third. And here is Kyle Orton trying to get away from Grant and gets out of the tackle box and throws the ball away, bringing up fourth down. And right now, a game break. Let's go back to L.A. and Kurt Menefee.
Well, this one's for Baldy. With the number 2 seed all wrapped up, Green Bay's just playing backup. And his former Scottish Claymore, Craig Knoll, to the former Amsterdam Admiral, Ravel Martin, for the touchdown. Oh, laddie, they lead it 31-13. Baldy.
All right, Kurt, I know those NFL Europe alum have made a big impact in the league this year.
Fourth down, Brad Maynard will kick. And Lance Moore. Go out of bounds. 6:07 to go in the third quarter. You know, on that last fourth down attempt by the Saints, Marcus Colston didn't in one play in the second half, was not in there. Normally he'd be the fourth down reliable receiver for Brees. Back here at Soldier Field. Dick Stockton and Brian Baldinger. The Bears lead 31-17. Terrence Copper to the right of your pitcher. First down. Drew Brees. And a pass thrown behind David Patton. And for a report, let's go down to Mike Hall.
Got an update on Marcus Colston. He's got his helmet off walking the sidelines. The team still officially won't say there's anything wrong with him, but I've seen him wincing and grabbing his left hand. They also put a special pad, it looked like, underneath his glove on the back side of his hand. And again, he's still helmet off on the sideline, guys.
All right, Mike. And of course, the Saints really are limited, and that's their game, the passing game, without Colston. And it really might have affected them on that 4th and 2. Colston was not in the game. Second down and 10. And there's the screen to Pierre Thomas. And Thomas is tackled down at the 24 by Urlacher and Hillenmeyer. Drew Brees, 2 touchdowns and 2 interceptions. And setting the NFL record for completions in a year. Thomas having a big game as a runner and as a receiver, and Marcus Colston with 2 touchdown grabs heading the receiving core for New Orleans.
And make no question about it, this core is led by Marcus Colston. With him on the sidelines right now, it limits Drew Brees and some of the things he likes to look at.
Third down and 3. Pass out to Terrence Copper, and Copper will be prevented by Brian Urlacher from getting the first down. Big play by Urlacher, who had an interception earlier in the game, and that will bring up.
Watch Brian fourth jump down here, Dick. I mean, he just takes off as soon as he sees the ball outside there. I mean, forget about the angles. Let's get to the sidelines as quickly as I can, knock him down here, and keep him short of the first down. A real impact play by Brian on that key third down.
And you notice that Alex Brown almost got a hand on that one, try to anticipate it. So the Devin Hester adventure continues. Hester returning the punt 64 yards earlier here in the third quarter. Weatherford with the punt. And it takes a Bear bounce, and the Bears will take it at the 47-yard line near midfield. So Brian Urlacher, who's been bothered by a bad back all year, has made some sparkling plays today for Chicago. Following the 28-yard punt by Weatherford, Bears will start at the 47-yard line. So the strategy with Devin Hester is backfired, and there's the flip to Devin Hester, who's going to throw. Can't find a target and is knocked back for a loss at the 32 by Roman Harper. So some razzle-dazzle involving Hester again doesn't work, and a loss on the play.
Well, it's a bad play that backfired, but I give the Bears credit for it. That's Sean Payton, the last time that they punted the ball to Devin Hester. And he was telling Steve Weatherford, why can't you just punt it out of bounds like we talked about all week? That was the game plan.
Meanwhile, the Bears lose 15 yards. Second down and 25. Garrett Wolfe gets the handoff, trying to bounce it outside, and Wolfe is knocked back by Scott Fujita. So the Bears going in reverse here with 3:45 to go in the third.
Dick, when you look at the Bears and you look at the personnel they have on the field, when you have Hester and Berrien on the field at the same time, immediately every alert in your head goes off. Deep ball, trick plays, and when you got two guys that can stretch the field the way they speedsters can, the safeties are forced to play deep.
And Rasheed Davis going out to the left, along with Berrien. Pressure on Orton. He dumps it off to Garrett Wolfe. Wolfe still on his feet, coming to the outside. Big run by Wolfe after the catch, and goes out of bounds, picks up the first down. A big play for the Bears into Saint territory, 32 yards for Chicago.
And here's the role of Garrett Wolfe, because it's just a screen pass here, trying to get as many yards as they can. It does a good job of just kind of bouncing off the interior lineman, and that's what he can give you there, that type of balance, and then the big play ability, the stretch ability. And suddenly this Bear offense in week 16 looks explosive.
32 yards after the catch for Garrett Wolfe. The first down. And here's Wolfe again. And He has knocked back a loss of a yard on the play, and you talk about that offense. Their most points that the Bears have scored was an overtime victory back in November against Denver. They got 37-35 last week against Green Bay.
Well, you know, in that game against Denver, Hester returned two for touchdowns, and so when they do score a lot, Hester is really at the, you know, at the crux of that. Scored two touchdowns here today.
55-yard touchdown catch and a 64-yard punt return. Adrian Peterson back in there for the Bears. Pressure on Orton. Gets the ball knocked away. Loose ball. And McKee covers up for the Bears at the 46. Once again, the Saints putting huge pressure on Kyle Orton.
Well, they come with the blitz here. Harper, the free safety, comes clean. Gets that ball out of Orton's hands. And now, one of the hardest things to do, Hollis Thomas trying to grab that ball, is just recovering fumbles in this league is such a problem. Teams don't practice it enough, and there is a skill to it, to get to the side of it and scoop it up and bring it to your body rather than trying to fall right on the top of it.
There is Hester to the top of your picture right now. On third down at 17 with under a minute and a half remaining in the third. Orton going to the tight end, Greg Olsen up the middle. Good tackle made by Osama Young, the nickelback, preventing the first down. Although the Bears do get 12 yards out of it to the 34.
Orton wants to go for it, and he may have just talked Ron Turner and Lovie Smith into it. Good open field tackle by Young. You're seeing all the weapons here in Chicago right now. You're seeing Barry, and you're seeing Devin Hester, Greg Olsen, and that was sort of the plan all along, was to take that Super Bowl team and add Hester to the offense and Greg Olsen. It just hadn't really materialized yet.
You're looking at Kyle Orton, who's done nothing but win. He's 11-6 as a starter in his career. Fourth down and five. And here is Orton with a pump fake and a pass to Olsen. And not much of an angle downfield, and Kevin Casemahorn covering. And so the Saints will take over on downs. Bears gave it their shot with less than a half a minute remaining in the third. 29 seconds remaining in the third. And the Bears looking to finish the season with back-to-back wins. It would be the first time they've done that. And Marcus Colston still has not come back to the lineup. Big operative in their offense is Pierre Thomas, who's been terrific today. And Thomas getting up to the 41.
Marcus Colston with that problem with his left hand, he can't squeeze it right now. So if you throw the ball to him, he can't grip it enough to get the ball to his body. So I don't know if we'll see him the rest of the afternoon.
Eight catches, 94 yards as the final seconds tick off, ending the quarter. Saints needing a win to stay alive and then help. That's the end of the third quarter. The Bears lead it 31-17. Well, the Winter Olympics can't be that far away, Brian.
No. Never a bad day when you're out there taking advantage of a little sled riding hill.
Pierre Thomas driving for the first down and gets it to the 36. Thomas now with 148 total yards today. And what a great start to his first game ever in Chicago. Growing up in Lindbergh, Illinois, 28 miles south of Soldier Field, and a White Sox fan from Southside.
Well, he's the White Sox fan, but members of his family are Cub fans, and that led to quite a few family feuds.
He wasn't getting tickets for the family members who the Cubs fans.
Now you draw the line.
Here's Thomas again going outside, and another big run and first down. Pierre Thomas, as he goes out of bounds at the 41, getting 13. These are the numbers of the third quarter only.
See that the Bears have had no rushing attack in that. The only score was the punt return for a touchdown by Devin Hester, who is the difference in this game today. And as Pierre Thomas comes off the field to put the shoe back on.
And you're absolutely right. Hester the key. You look at those numbers, you think the Saints are rolling all over
the
Bears.
So. No, but it's been the big playability of Devin Hester. He's averaged over 40 yards a touchdown in his career.
Here's Brees trying to get something going. and unable to get it to Chris Barkley, who was assigned this week. Played four games with the Tennessee Titans and has been the kickoff return man for New Orleans today. So it'll be second down and 10.
The only thing we haven't seen from Pierre Thomas, and it's been a great debut here in Soldier Field for him, is the big run, you know, where he can break through into the second level and then show his breakaway speed. You know, if he has that element to his game, this is a guy that you can say can line up and play tailback for us looking ahead to next year.
At over 100 rushing yards for the first time in his career. And there is Brees stepping up, and Brees goes down, loses the ball. And the scramble is on. Urlacher has given his opinion, and he's right. The Bears get it back. Fumble and a turnover to the disdain of Sean Payton. Loss of 7.
I think it's going to be Tommy Harris that's going to come free, and he does. Blindly just strips that ball out of Brees' hand. Brees is trying to keep it close to his body to protect it, and Harris came and stripped it, and the Bears have been feasting off turnovers the last few weeks.
3 turnovers today by New Orleans. We'll be back.
Today's game on Fox is sponsored by MasterCard, by State Farm, proud sponsor of the NFL, by Miller Lite, for award-winning taste, there's no debate. Miller Lite, good call. And by the new.
First down for the Bears, and Adrian Peterson carries to the 48-yard line of the Saints. Alex Brown on the recovery of the fumble. The third turnover of the game by the Saints. So the Bears up by 2 touchdowns early in this fourth quarter. And right now in control of this game, and their defense has really stymied the Saints today.
And the Bears look like a good team. They look like the team that went to the NFC Championship game against the Saints last year and got to the Super Bowl. The guys are making plays, whether it's Tommy Harris with the forced fumble, Alex Brown with the recovery, Urlacher with the interception. The guys have defended the pass well.
Second down and 6. Peterson. Not much running room. Bruce Smith is right there. And this is exactly what Lovie Smith envisioned coming into this game. Remember, he beat the Green Bay Packers. When he came to Chicago, he said, my first goal is to beat the Packers this year, despite the disappointing campaign. If the Bears win, they'll go 7-9. He would have swept Green Bay, including last week, knocking out of a possible home field advantage throughout the playoffs, and today well on their way towards knocking out the Saints for the playoffs. Injury timeout will return. Always a bonus for the Bears when they beat the Packers, when they beat them twice. Well, you know what that means. And the Bear fans, incredibly loyal here, and a great tradition. There'll be some questions that need to be answered during the offseason for this franchise. Horton's pass caught for the first down by Musa Muhammad.
And those are some of the questions right there. You know, does Musa Muhammad return next year? Does Bernard Berrien, who will be a free agent and will be a high-priced free agent, I believe. I think he'll maybe be one of the top wide receivers out there in the market this year.
Lance Briggs, of course,
Lance Briggs.
And let's not forget Rex Grossman.
And Rex Grossman with the future of him. So they've got some, Jerry Angelo, the general manager, Lovie, they've got some big decisions to make when this game finishes.
And another big one is Brendan Iabateo, who's the special teams performer in the Pro Bowl. Peterson is wrapped up immediately by Kendrick Clancy.
The other big decision, I think, Dick, is what are they going to do at running back? I mean, Cedric Benson, look, the fourth pick in the draft, he wasn't productive enough when he was out there this year. And this game is, and this team is built around the run game. We all know that Thomas Jones left for free agency. Weren't able to keep both of them. I think they let the wrong guy go. But can you win, and can you run the style of football that you want, that Lovie Smith would like, with Cedric Benson? They've got to answer that question this offseason.
That's what they've done today, and came in 31st in the league in rushing. Second down and 11 for Orton. His pass is picked off. Interception by Jason David. So David gets it back, and that's the 6th turnover of the game, 3 by each club. Berrien was the target, so the Saints, with plenty of time, hanging in there with another chance. Third interception of the year by Jason David, giving the Saints the ball in their own territory. First down on their 32. Drew Brees firing away, goes underneath to Eric Johnson, the tight end, who gets 9 yards.
I think let's take a look at that last interception from Kyle Orton. Throwing it to Bernard Berrien here. He's just late with this ball. And Jason David, who's playing there, he gets a great look at it. Gets a good jump and a jump on that ball. And Kyle Orton will be the first one to tell you that you can't hurt the team up 14 points in this situation to give the Saints life.
Second and one, Thomas. And he gets the first down to the 46-yard line. So the two former Boilermakers, Drew Brees and Kyle Orton, and those are their numbers today. Orton has the higher rating, and that interception is first in a couple of games, and those are the numbers with Drew Brees with 211 yards. But when you talk about the Bears with the running back and the quarterback problems, you don't know if the situation's any better than it was after last year ended. Brees completes to Patton, who's down to the 50. Gain of five. Well, tomorrow night, starting at 11 p.m., celebrate New Year's Eve with Cap Dealey and Spike Ferriston. That will be live. Don't miss exclusive previews of this year's BCS games and special performances from Fall Out Boy and Lifehouse. New Year's Eve live tomorrow at 11 p.m. on Fox. And the Saints have suffered some injuries in this game, which affected their offense. Pass thrown underneath to Thomas. And a first down to the Bear 40-yard line. We'll tell you about those. But first, let's go to Kurt Menefee for a game break.
Well, Dick, just a reminder that when your game is done, it's game two of our Fox NFL Sunday doubleheader. Most of you will see Tony Romo and the Cowboys taking on Clinton Portis and the Washington Redskins. And keep in mind, if the Redskins win that game, they are in the playoffs.
That's right, Kurt. They control their own destiny. And the Saints trailing by 14. Need to win to keep their hopes alive. First down, and Brees has it knocked away. And it was Alex Brown once again. Very active game for Alex Brown at defensive end.
A lot of batted balls down here today, too. And Brees is approaching 50 attempts here today. Alex Brown just falls off here, and they're told, look, if you can't get to the quarterback, get your hands up. I mean, the one knock on Drew Brees has always been going back to Westlake High School in Austin, Texas, Purdue and West Lafayette, Indiana, is, you know, just barely 6 foot. You know, you can get your hands in front of the ball right there. You can bat it down just as good as anything else you can do to it.
That was Brown's third deflection of the game, and the handoff to Thomas. And Thomas is stopped at the 40 by Trumaine McBride. Talking about the Saints' problems, of course, Marcus Colston, who has been the main target today and throughout the season for Drew Brees, out with the injured wrist. But Terrence Copper is also sidelined with a concussion. Josh Bullocks, the safety, also out. So the Saints right now are decimated at the worst time for them. Third down and 10 on the Bears 40. Brees completes the pass to Johnson. But he won't get the first down as Lance Briggs prevents the first down. Lost their minus about a yard and a half, and slow getting up is Johnson, who's been hurt the last two games.
Eric Johnson has been in and out of the lineup. Former wide receiver at Yale has made the transition to tight end. One of those decisions that the Saints have to make. Going to be a free agent at the end of the season.
The big loss, Marcus Colston, really hurt New Orleans. And we're back here at Soldier Field, and for the fourth time, the Saints will try for the fourth down conversion. They need three.
Take a look at this last play from Eric Johnson. What happened to him?
Fourth down and three. Huge play for the Saints' survival in this game. Drew Brees. And Brees, under incredible pressure, and led by Adewale Ogunleye, trying to get it to Pierre Thomas, incomplete, and the Bears take over on down.
And the Bears are having fun playing football. I mean, they're just teeing off right now. They're getting great jumps on the shotgun snap, and they're teeing off right now. And this is what the Bears have been hoping to play like all year long. I know Lovie Smith is enjoying it, and Drew Brees is having no fun out there right now.
Bears beat the Saints for the right to go to the Super Bowl last year, and leading here 31-17 with 8 minutes to go. Garrett Wolf, the rookie from Northern Illinois, nothing on first down. And a timeout called by the Saints. That'll be their second timeout, left with one. And Sean Payton over there discussing things with Bill Levy. Want to remind you, coming up next, the NFL on Fox. The big one, the Cowboys against the Redskins. And of course, the Redskins control their destiny. Victory for them puts them in the playoffs as the number six seed. And action next week. And the Dallas Cowboys, who have the home field advantage throughout the NFC, have to think about the playoffs, maybe resting some people, but want to knock the Redskins out.
The last thing the Redskins can think about later this afternoon is, well, the Cowboys aren't going to play their starters. They're not going to try to win. If you start thinking like that, then the Redskins won't win that game.
Peterson for a couple. You saw Roberto Garza come off the field and replaced by Terrence Metcalf. Gain of 4 yards on the play, but you're absolutely right. I mean, you play a game. You play 16 games. Fans pay full price to see those games, and the players get paid for 16.
Cowboys are going to give it a good shot out there today. We'll see Brad Johnson. But for the Redskins, who are going to try to win their fourth game in a row, it all started in their turnaround against the Bears when Todd Collins came in the game when Jason Campbell went down. This team has elevated their play, trying to win their fourth game and into the playoffs.
And can the Collins magic continue? Devin Hester to the bottom of your picture now. Third down and 5. And it's a running play to Peterson. He's got the first down. Adrian Peterson gets to the 47-yard line. A 10-yard pickup and a first down as the clock runs. Under 7 minutes to go in the fourth.
That's the type of run where the offensive linemen inside themselves are just celebrating. Third down, they put it in the running back's hands. They put it on themselves. And they can let that clock, they can look at the clock, and they can see that thing just keep ticking right there. And they get a little bit closer to that second win in a row.
And Peterson now with 82 yards rushing, averaging 5 yards a carry. Going back to what you pointed out earlier, Lovie Smith saying that wherever I would go, Adrian Peterson would be part of my team, no matter what. This time, Peterson is knocked back for a loss of one.
Well, valuable today. I mean, throws a touchdown pass to Bernard Berry, you know, a huge play off the fake. Couldn't have executed it any better. He's been the major ball carrier here the last couple of weeks. And one of those guys, special teams, third down back, whatever you ask him to do, he can do it.
Saints have used their last timeout, so they have no timeouts remaining. 6:17 to go in the fourth, and the Bears up by 2 touchdowns. This field goal hit the ribbon. Mark Bradley with a touchdown. Great fade to Colston. And then, play you were talking about, Peterson throwing to Berrien. And then Marcus Colston with the score. And then the Devin Hester show. 55 yards as a receiver for a score and a 64-yard punt return.
It was the 8th touchdown that Devin Hester has scored this year. I would expect that I think maybe even double next year. A much bigger role in this offense.
Put his toe in the water this year, so to speak. Peterson gets into Saints territory to the 49-yard line, and the Bears using up the clock effectively. New Orleans out of timeouts. 2-yard pickup on that play.
You know, you look at the Bears drafts and what they've done. I mean, what bigger impact guy could they have taken but Devin Hester? And really, the impact that Hester has had in this league will going into the draft this year, teams are going to be scouting the entire country looking for the next Devin Hester, a guy that could play that kind of role and have that kind of impact throughout the team.
Hester coming in motion to the bottom, third down and seven, makes the grab, loses it, incomplete. Incomplete pass, bringing up fourth down.
Part of being Devin Hester is drawing a crowd every time and everywhere you go. I mean, he comes on the feet, on the field, people start screaming for him. He's in motion here, and they're all running. They're screaming his name, his number, that they think that he's going to get the ball, which he is the featured guy on that play, and they were ready for it.
Brad Maynard will be kicking to Lance Moore. Moore will let it bounce. Takes a bear hop. And out of bounds at about the three. So a great kick by the NFC Special Teams Player of the Week, Brad Maynard. Well, next Sunday, the NFL's second season begins as the NFC's best teams go head-to-head to see which two have the drive, determination, and desire to advance to the championship game. Coverage of the NFC playoffs begins next Sunday with the wild card in high definition only on Fox. And, of course, the Super Bowl will be seen on Fox this year out in Glendale, Arizona. And the big question is, will the New England Patriots, who completed a 16-0 regular season, win the two games to get to the Super Bowl? What a show that would be. From the end zone, Drew Brees trying to find a receiver. And the pass is ruled a catch to David Patton. And a first down for the Saints.
Great effort by David Patton to come back and stretch out for that ball and not allow it to hit the ground. Brees has got to find a new go-to guy without Colston in the lineup. All smaller receivers out there, not quite the targets, nowhere near the targets that Colston are.
15 yards on the last play. First down on the 18. And stoppage of play.
And it's going to be a challenge, I think, from Lovie Smith, whether David Patton caught the ball on the last throw. And I don't know if it's like Lovie Smith got the flag out in
Chicago time. Is challenging the ruling on the field that the pass was complete. We'll review the play.
First challenge for the Bears.
Well, from that angle, you can't see if the ball hit the ground. Good job by David Patton of selling it like he caught the ball. Good enough for the side judge to say that he did.
Because the side judge was looking at exactly the right spot. Looking at the Bears' season. The three losses in a row, we talked about the Denver win in overtime to the Giants, a game that the Bears seemingly had in hand, and then losing by 8 points at Washington and then seven at Minnesota before the win over Green Bay last week.
Here's another look at the play to David Patton on the sideline. Well, Lovie Smith, I think, has got himself a win here. That looks like a one-hopper by Patton.
Now, these coaches have people upstairs that are looking at the play and will advise the head coach, throw your red flag.
One thing that Lovie Smith, as I think he'll win this challenge, he was saying is just the fine line in this league between winning and losing. You know, what's the difference? Last year, here you are. This time of the year, getting ready to play an NFC Championship game. You know, and then you fall off as much as they did this year. And he's saying it's a play here. It's a play there, a little more consistency, you know, at the quarterback position and at the safety position, which really hurt him this year.
Well, six of the last teams which lost in the Super Bowl failed to even make the playoffs the following year. So, you know, that's evidence alone how tough it is. Well, Bill Levy has seen it. Here's what he said.
After reviewing the play, the ball hit the ground. It's an incomplete pass. With the timer for 5:20 on the game clock, 5:20, Chicago will not be charged a timeout. It'll be second and 10 on the 4-yard line.
Well, they got it right. That's the important thing here. So the Bears defense again has the Saints backed up where their end zone is, and the fans, they're enjoying this. This is sort of a tribute to them right there. Defense right in front of them, on their feet, cheering them on.
Second and 10 out of the shotgun is Brees. Steps up, flag is down, dumps it off to Pierre Thomas, who's tackled shy of the 10-yard line by Briggs.
If this is a hold in the end zone, it'll be a
holding.
Safety.
Number 73 offense in the end zone. He's open to play on safety.
Right on it, Brian. And I know you never did hold in the end zone for a safety when you were an offensive lineman.
I hit really well if I did. And Alex Brown's going to be out here having a heck of a two-game audition for his job back next year. And then that's right there. You see Jahri Evans holding Tommy Harris. They had a safety against the Saints in that NFC Championship game last year here.
Against Drew Brees, so...
That's
Drew Brees now. The safety, 2 points, adding to the Bears' lead. And it's 33-17, and the Bears will get the ball back on a free kick coming up by the Saints. So, cause for celebration, and it will be a happy new year for Bears, knocked out of the playoffs after going to the Super Bowl last year. But obviously finishing in strong fashion, scoring over 30 points and beating the Packers last week and again today against New Orleans.
And that's all you can ask for as your head coach, you know, is to play the game. You know, this looks like a good Bears team the last 2 weeks here. You know, you knocked the Packers out last week. They're fighting for home field advantage and throughout the NFC playoffs. And then you trying to eliminate the Saints here from any playoff contention, playing their best football right here at the end.
And you said it earlier, you know, cynics will say, well, where were you early in the year when the games meant a lot more? Well, just check the Green Bay Packers, and you talked about their four wins last year to complete the season, and what a forerunner that was to their campaign this year.
Well, you talk to the Packers, to a man, and they'll tell you that that was really important to win those last four, including one against the Bears that allowed them to kind of springboard into the offseason, fix a couple of things that weren't right, get Brett Favre healthy, and here they are. They're going to have a first-round bye.
Free kick, Steve Weatherford, and Devin Hester, the deep man, but is picked up by the short man, Rasheed Davis. Davis turning the corner and will go out of bounds at the 46. Well, this week, the All-State Bowl Bash comes to Fox, beginning with the AT&T Cotton Bowl Classic, followed by the All-State Sugar Bowl, the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl, the FedEx Orange Bowl, and concluding with the All-State BCS National Championship game between LSU and Ohio State. That'll be a heck of a game. The All-State Bowl Bash begins New Year's Day, only on Fox. Adrian Peterson bounces off a defender and a stop at the 45. And of course, Brian, you're taking off for Dallas for the Cotton Bowl game. Tell us about Arkansas and Missouri.
Well, Arkansas is one of the best running teams in football. In fact, they've got two running backs eligible for the draft that may be first round picks. Darren McFadden, runner up to the Heisman this year. Doak Walker Award winner, along with Felix Jones, who Lovie Smith knew a great deal about coming out of Booker T. Washington High School in Tulsa. Recruited that area when he was at Tulsa for a long time. Confirmed just how good both those backs are.
Under 4.5 to go in the game. Second down and 10. Here's Peterson up the middle and getting close to midfield.
And on the other side, Chase Daniels was in the running for Heisman Trophy and invited there. Runs a spread wide open offense at Missouri. And when you look at the college game, Dick, and you look at a lot of these bowl games that people are watching, you see a lot of the innovation from college creeping into the NFL.
Well, you asked Lovie Smith about that. Mm-hmm. And, of course, he follows the college game, obviously, very closely, as all the head coaches do, and he sees the same thing.
Yeah, I mean, you know, if you want to find, you know, new wrinkles in the passing game, it's being done right now throughout college football.
Third down and 5 for the Bears. Comfortably in front here, 33-17 with 3:41 to go. And Peterson will be stopped at the 49, bringing up fourth down and a little more than 3 yards. Brian Urlacher with an interception in the first quarter, which led to a field goal that gave the Bears a 3-0 lead. They have never trailed in this game. They were up at different stages of the game, 10-0, 17-7, 24-14. Saints came within 7 points after three quarters, but Devin Hester with the 64-yard punt return for a touchdown and then the safety, and that is where we are.
Well, he broke the game open, and that's what he is. He's a game breaker. Everybody wants one. The Bears have one. I think this offseason will be spent trying to figure out how he can impact the games even more.
Bears will call a timeout. That'll be their first, and it comes with 2:55 in the fourth. So the Saints here in week 17 trailing here and knew they had to win and hope that the Redskins would lose to the Cowboys and the Vikings lose in Denver to the Broncos. But it looks like their playoff dream is coming to an end.
We see it every year, Dick. Teams that have everything to play for, everything in front of them to go win the game to advance, it's hard to do because the other team is trying to win just as hard. Forget about that they're out of the playoffs. We saw the Eagles defeat the Saints last week. We saw the Bengals beat the Browns. We saw the Vikings lose. All these teams with a great deal to play for. You know what? The other team wants to win just as bad regardless of the situation.
Maynard will kick following the timeout. And Lance Poor back deep for the Saints. Saints coming in trying to get a piece of it. And the ball will go out of bounds at the 12-yard line. Whoever thought that the Chicago Bears would go under 500 this year? We know about the loser of Super Bowls and the problems they have, but to have this kind of a year was a shock to a lot of their supporters.
Well, I think they had some misfortune early on. I mean, I think when they lost Mike Brown right at the beginning of the season, I mean, that's the guy that really helped make this secondary special. I mean, they had a safety there like the Indianapolis Colts have Bob Sanders that can prevent the big plays. The big plays hurt the Bears defense all year. They gave up a number of them.
Nathan Basher's injury problems as well, as Pierre Thomas on the screen pass making the most of his opportunity, gets the first down. Ogunleye making the tackle in a gain of 11 yards. But it'll be interesting to see what the Bears do as far as quarterback and running back, as he talked about, much less seeing whether they can keep Lance Briggs, Berrien, and some of the others. Brees goes underneath to Thomas. Down at the 32 by Briggs. He gets 8 on that one. And we're going to get to our 2-minute warning as the Saints line up. So 2 minutes remain in this game here at Soldier Field. The Bears up.
Some snapshots to capture today. Brian Urlacher with another interception and a celebration to follow. And how about just a cool breeze in the Windy City? Devin Hester doing some damage again, and the disdain of Sean Payton saying, how in the world did we let that guy do that? And Devin Hester saying, it's all about the ball, and I'm happy to be in Chicago playing.
Cool breeze, and the pass caught by David Patton. And they get it up to the 49-yard line, 16-yard gain. Saints out of timeouts, trailing 33-17, but playing as if this game were much closer than that. First down with nearly a minute and a half to go. Brees again, and it's caught by Billy Miller. He should get the first down. And the ball at the 41-yard line after the 11-yard pickup. Well, you really have to credit the NFL players like from the Bears and Giants playing as hard as they have down the stretch. And for those of you in the home markets of our late games, in a moment, you will be leaving this game, and we will be switching you to the start of your game. Pierre Thomas with an 11-yard pickup and another first down for the Saints.
Been a big bright spot here for the Saints today. Disappointing performance, disappointing outcome, but I think they had themselves a player in Pierre Thomas.
Brees still fighting. Completes to Billy Miller. And Miller gets it to the 21-yard line with 40 seconds to go. Well, the Saints' big opportunity came that home game against Tampa Bay several weeks ago. They were in position now to take the momentum on their side. Lost with a 23-20 lead. Pass again to Thomas, and he is stopped. But New Orleans, they've got enough to come back next year as well. 15 seconds to go.
Derek Thomas with over 100 yards rushing and 100 yards receiving today. Played right out of his shoe a couple of times today as well, too.
Including right now, Drew Brees, NFL single season record for completions, also a career record for attempts with 59. You mentioned Pierre Thomas. Colston with 168 career receptions, the most in the first 2 years of a career, but he got hurt. Kyle Orton wins again. Devin Hester, two touchdowns. How spectacular was that? Final seconds here, and Brees going inside, and Pierre Thomas in for the touchdown. So Thomas, a Bear fan throughout his life, stepping foot in a Soldier Field for the first time ever and having a brilliant game in defeat, wants the ball and deserves the ball, and great for Pierre Thomas, the rookie from the University of Illinois.
He came back for the holidays. He was to visit Linwood, Illinois, and they're going to be happy in the hometown. Reese here going to try for the two-point conversion.
226 total yards for Pierre Thomas, 33-23, 7 seconds to go, and Thomas will walk in for the two-point conversion. So it's an eight-point game, one possession game, but only 7 seconds and no timeouts remaining. How about Pierre Thomas's game today, Brian?
Well, I wonder if they missed out on Pierre Thomas this year. I wonder if earlier in the year when Deuce McAllister went down, had they played Pierre Thomas, what kind of a difference he might have been to this offense.
And he dreamed of this in his house, dreamed of playing at Soldier Field, but he couldn't have dreamed of what he accomplished today.
Yeah, you know, the only thing that would make it better is if they had a winning cause here today. Von Turner told me down on the field before the game that when he recruited Pierre Thomas out of Linwood, Illinois, out of the high school there, that he thought he would one day win the Heisman Trophy. He thought he had that kind of talent. Injury kind of slowed him down, but you can see that he is a legitimate NFL running back, and you never know about any of these guys, like about a Ryan Grant or Ernest Graham, until you give him the ball and you give him a chance.
7 seconds remaining, and of course the onside kick coming up here. The ball has to go 10 yards. And Devin Hester is like the safety man back at the 30. And Martin Gramatica will do the kicking. Hester is at the 30, and all the other guys who can handle the football, whether they are linebackers, receivers, tight ends, or backs, are up front at the 40.
Ah, the old switcheroo.
And the Bears call a timeout. So they want to really see what's going on, and Sean Payton was kind of wondering, I could see if you read lips,
yeah,
why the Saints didn't get that onside kickoff faster.
Sean Payton is not going to leave Soldier Field in Chicago today in a good mood, not just for what happened today, but over the course of this whole season. Starting the season off 0-4 in a deep hole, getting out of the hole, and then playing highly inconsistent the rest of the way on.
Meanwhile, Lovie Smith got just what he wanted if the Bears can hold on, and it would be a miracle for the Saints because the timeout factor and the clock works against them, and we're ready for the onside kick attempt again. Drew Brees had said, whether we get into the playoffs or not, 8-8 is a lot better than 7-9.
Well, it's the difference between a losing record and a non-losing record.
Right. So it'll be the Redskins or the Vikings. And it's recovered by Rasheed Davis. And that you do it with 6 seconds to go. The Saints will drop to 7-9, and the Chicago Bears, by winning their last two and the first time this year they have won back-to-back games, will finish the year at 7-9 as well. And of course, we'll be back at Soldier Field at the conclusion of this game. 6 seconds remain. Pretty good offense the last 2 weeks, and however they did it, Kyle Orton engineered it, right?
Yeah, 12-6 as a starter now. And the team wins when he's there. He made a couple of big throws today to help his cause.
So the game is over, and the Chicago Bears have defeated the New Orleans Saints by a score of 33-25. So this is Dick Stockton for Brian Baldinger saying so long. Stay tuned for the second half of this Fox doubleheader as the Redskins face the Cowboys, or the Vikings and the Broncos. So long, everybody.